In your strength, O Lord, the just one rejoices. How greatly your salvation makes him glad. You have granted him his soul's desire. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, today we celebrate the Feast of St. Louis, King of France. So let us ask the saint to pray for us and pray with us in this holy mass. And before celebrating the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for forgiveness and mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring the dead to life and the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who brought St. Louis from the chaos of earthly rule to the glory of a heavenly realm, grant, we pray, to his intercession, that by fulfilling our duties on earth, we may seek out your eternal kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We ask you, brothers and sisters, with regard to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our assembling with him, not to be shaken out of your minds suddenly, or to be alarmed either by a spirit or by an oral statement, or by a letter allegedly from us to the effect that the day of the Lord is at hand. Let no one deceive you in any way. To this end, he also called you through our gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught, either by an oral statement or by a letter of ours. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting encouragement and good hope through his grace, encourage your hearts and strengthen them in every good deed and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the peoples with equity.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
Before the Lord, for he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice, and the peoples with his constancy.
The Lord comes to judge the earth.
May the Lord be in your heart upon the lips, and you may proclaim his gospel with you in breath, in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The word of God is living and effective, able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites. You pay tithes of mint and dill and cumin, and have neglected the weightier things of the law, judgment and mercy and fidelity. But these you should have done without neglecting the others. Blind guides who strain out the gnat and swallow the camel. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You cleanse the outside of cup and dish, but inside they are full of plunder and self-indulgence. Blind Pharisee, clean first the inside of the cup, so that the outside also may be clean. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Pharisees still exist today. Sometimes I accuse myself of being a Pharisee. I am a Pharisee when I say, thank God I am not like so-and-so. I am a Pharisee when I call someone a sinner because he or she does not worship God the same way as I do. I am a Pharisee when I say that my way of worship is better and holier than others. For example, people discuss which form of the Holy Mass is better and holier, the extraordinary form of the Mass, also known as the traditional Latin Mass, or the ordinary form of the new Mass. It is okay to have a preference, but to say that my way is better and holier than yours is not okay. That's when Christ leads me. I think the more legitimate question should be, does my worship come from my heart? Which form is speaking to my heart? They are the two forms of the one and the same mystery, the holy sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. I am a Pharisee when I focus too much on the outside and neglect the inside. I am a Pharisee when I give too much attention to the outward appearance while neglecting the heart. So sisters and brothers, let us ask the Lord to increase in us the virtue of humility and charity, that we can focus on Him only and welcome others into our hearts. Let us pray. With faith and trust, we bring our needs and the needs of our brothers and sisters to the Lord. For all members of the Holy Mother Church, may Christ keep us faithful to the gospel. We pray to the Lord. For all people of the world, may the Lord's love and mercy be upon us and give us and bring us to salvation. We pray to the Lord. For those who live each day with fears and anxieties, may the Holy Spirit be their comfort and strength. We pray to the Lord. For our St. Anne parish and school, may God continue to fill us with His gifts and graces. We pray to the Lord. For the faithful departed, especially those among our loved ones, may the Lord welcome them into His eternal peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for always hearing our prayers. Please answer them according to your holy will. This we ask to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of the Church.
To the present oblation, O Lord, which we offer in commemoration of Blessed Louis, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to our Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord, for in the marvelous confession of your sins, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation, we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down the Spirit upon them like a newfold, so that they may become for us the body and blood our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into a life of your face. Have mercy on us, O we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me, says the Lord. we pray the spiritual communion prayer with our brothers and sisters who joined us last year. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and deny myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, in commemoration of St. Louis, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
To kneel at your altar, in faith we draw near. Let onward my Mary, your daughter so dear. O good Saviour, we call on your name, your praises love, your children proclaim. O
in heaven.
Give
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be,
our
Lord God. Amen.
Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary,
pray for us.
The third mystery, we meditate on God becoming man, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into
temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be,
Lord God.
Amen.
Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary,
pray for us.
Good Saint Anne, you were privileged to be the Mother of Heaven, God's Mother and ours. And so you hold a faithful place among the saints. We thank you with confidence because of your closeness to Mary, and also because you have always shown your power and willingness to have those devoted to you. Through this nobleness and end, I ask you to help me each day to come closer to Jesus through Mary. Give me your power for sin, which separates me from God, and teach me to love my neighbor as myself. I place before you the special intentions of this novena. Please recommend them to Mary, that she may bring them before her Son Jesus. Intercede for me, Saint Anne, that I may follow Jesus more closely in the vocation in life to which he has called me, so that when this life is over, I might marry and you and all the saints enjoy the vision of God face to face. Amen. Ever Immaculate Virgin, Mother of Mercy, help of the sick, refuge of sinners, comfort of the afflicted, you know my loss, my troubles, my suffering. Then you cast upon me a look of mercy, by appearing in the heart of the Lord, you will please to make the prayer of the sanctuary. gratitude for your favors. I will endeavor to maintain your virtues. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To the possession of St. Anne, may the Lord bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.